will of God. Emana Zaya Tana. Owa Nagabaliana Nana Masaya. Ela Mashanda. Abala Baba. You are activating your spirit man. Ela Maziata. Akowa Naha. You are rising above the flesh. You are taking charge of your life. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Emma Karanda. You are bringing your body under subjection. Emala Zakaya. Owa Nakiana Gaba. For he that speaketh in an unknown tongue edifies himself, builds his life. Ilabashe yama amalo bosaya oka yokale alamaziata enamazala elamazala lalabashia da laba alabali alabaya balababa elamama mama. That glorious life that was ordained for my glory. He that speaketh in an unknown tongues, speaketh in mysteries. Ela mazaha, but nevertheless, you are not speaking the wisdom of man. You are speaking the wisdom of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Ela mashega la bayaba, la mazaha, rada segaya, ema kala mamaha. Every wisdom that was ordained for your glory. Ela kasamaha, you will lay hold on it. Emege magaha.
In the name of Jesus, came my labor, your boss,
mama ado zakata emaka. For wherever the word of the king is, there is power. In the name of Jesus, ilasieta agalama. You are making laws in the realm of the spirit. Emelebosaya emananaha. You are saying to the seer, you come this far. Elebasha lamazaya agalaba. You are speaking to the mountains. Emala, be thou removed in the name of Jesus. Legasaya abalaba. Ale mama ananana masaya. Ala derasia. Ala baba baba. Ayo la la lasha. Elasha. Elasha. Amalaba. Amalaba. Ayala baba baba. Leba raba. Ala baba baba. Aleba. Oh ala shanda. Ala bashe. Ayaloza. Yala. Ayayayaya. Amalana. Amanana. 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 I break away from the past. For he that is born of God is a new creation. Behold, Elasia, the past is gone. Enasa, Alisa, Ogasa, Ikasa, Messiah, Alashia, Palabaya, Alabakaya, Alasia, Amanama, Abaraba. I insist on my God giving life. Elashaga, Amaleba, Ibalasa, Alamaradasa, Alaka. I am unstoppable in the name of Jesus. Inana masagos yaliga magura disa kaiwanisa karabadua shega. Let lies fall into pleasant places. Lies falling into pleasant places. Lies falling into pleasant places. Kia tusa kaiko kimaka kia kuwana darasha amaneka aleka. For I said, ye are God. For I said, ye are God. Eke rasa mayana alakedasa abala so aguate aika amanakia alakia alakia owashagaya arakaya malaya alasia oh aya adesa agala. I see the sun rising upon us. Ilashema yaya owanaka alasia alashaga. For the light shineth in darkness, and darkness comprehended not. You are the light that shineth brightest, and darkness ilasietos kayonakia palazia leka densha baliabo zeka owa nakabaya adarapa la baza malebarakados alialalasha emarapaya ananamasia orataleba. Here I was stuck. Inanamasubaratos, Alalaba Shigretaga, Kuyamakuania Kelebashega, Maliamo Zagratayago, Yaleona Zirama Zagoba Zalebalaba, Ikolobo Sigo Zagaligo, Yako Ragalia Maguza, Limala Baigona Magalia, Ona Galia no Zegia, Yako Rameana Giana, Ayagalaba Zalaba Shena, Le Marabayabo Zegadaba, Yamalabayaba. Ana malo zaka ya garamalia baba baba ana maleho dazala ora kale gaya mala ana mala baya kai ona mazana la bazara ba ala malio na la bazaga ala bazala bazanga ala maya bariama ala magaleba ana malaza ala bazala ba ala bazala ba ala bazala ba ala Jaya Zora, I go Zalabayaba, Alabaja, Amara Mayalaba, Amalabayaba, Alabayaba, Abariaba, Alabalabaya, Alabaya, Ayaya, 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 Ayaya. God. Elazaya, Alamaya, Alama, ask the Lord for a fresh encounter. Alamazalaba, Alamaya, Alagaya, Alaza, Alabaya, Alamaya, Alaba, Owalaya, Alazaya, Alamaya, Alamaya. So, Inanamasi. Oh, Jesus. Amen. Amen. We are still praying. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Lift your hands. Lift your hands unto the God. Lift your hands unto the Lord. Hug. Men praying everywhere, lifting up holy hands to God. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want us to do something prophetic. I'm reading the book of Romans, Romans 14, 7, 8. He says, for none of us live to himself. For none of us live to himself. And none dies to himself. For whether we live, we live to the Lord. Whether we live to the Lord. And whether we die to the Lord. Therefore, whether we live or we die, we are the Lord's. I want you to do something prophetic. I want you to bring your living. Your living is your daily doings. When you wake up, you're walking about in the realm of the Spirit. The way you go about, the way you order your life. You have to be intentional that your living is unto the Lord. Our living is unto the Lord. And I want you today to bring your living to God. I just want you to lay it on the altar. The Lord, if I live, Paul said, it is no longer I that liveth, that you will allow the Christ that lives within you to live out of you. Hallelujah. Working out your salvation with fear and trembling. Working it out. Working it out. Working it out. Working it out. The character and the nature of Christ. Hallelujah. And so you are going to pray. He says, 2 Corinthians 5:14, 5. For the love of Christ constrains us, because we have judged this, that one died for all. Therefore all died. And he died for all, that those who live may no longer live to themselves, but to him who died for them. That we will no longer live to himself. Say, I no longer live to myself. I live to him that died for me. And I want you to be intentional, even as we speak in tongues. Lift your voice and begin to pray. You are saying, Lord, I give you my living. Say, Lord, I live to you. I live to you, Lord. We lift. Come on, lift your voice. Let the Lord hear you. Say, my living is unto the Lord. For me to live as Christ. For me to live as Christ. For me to wake up as Christ. We thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Amen.
Hallelujah. Put your hands together for the Lord. Wherever you are, you just want to lift up your hands. Just glorify the name of God. Just bless his name. Just bless his name. Father, we love you. Wonderful, merciful Savior, precious Redeemer and friend, who would have thought that a lamb rescue the souls of men. Oh, you rescue the souls of men. Wonderful, say, wonderful, merciful Savior,
precious Redeemer and friend, who would atone that ever rescue the souls of men.
Oh, matchless love and beauty, endless worth. There's nothing in this world could satisfy. Jesus, you're the one more time, lift a voice. Who is like you, Lord?
Who is like you, Lord, in all the earth?
Come on, there's matchless love in you.
Matchless love and beauty, endless world.
So nothing in this world could satisfy. Come on, Jesus, you're.
Sorabo,
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 Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Lift up your voice and begin to bless the Lord. 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 Go ahead and bless the Lord. Ra ra bo she did ka ba ha da ba. Re mo sha ba ha da da ba ba. Dios ka da ba. La ba da ba da ba do she di be ka ba da ba. Le bro ske ba ha da da ba. La ha da da bo. Lift up your voice and begin to bless the Lord. 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 Le mo sha ba ha da da ba. Ha di mo she ka ba. Re mo di mo sha di di be ka ba. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We exalt your name. You alone are worthy to be praised. La ba di bo se di di be ka ba ba. Ya da da bo se di be ka ba ba. Ya da la ba ba. La da bo se di be ka ba. Lift up your hands wherever you are. Begin to bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And let everything within me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And let everything within me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul. And let everything within me bless his holy name. Lift up your voice and begin to bless the Lord. Remo shikapa adimo sata. Remo no mo shikapa ba. Limo no mo sata nebe kapa. Riba ba yendele mo kataraba. We bless you, Lord. We exalt your name. We glorify your name. We bless you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. You are the reason why I lift my hands. Why I lift my voice. Come on, lift it up to him. Why I sing to you. You are the reason I'm alive today. I am here to say, God, it's all because of you. Lift your voice. Come on, let me hear the church sing it. You want to personalize it. You want to personalize it. You have worshipers in this house. Let it out. Let it out. Out of the mouth. Let it out. You are the reason why. You are the reason why lifts my hands. Come on, lift it up to him. Let me hear men and women worship the Lord. He's the reason why. Yeah. I'm alive. I am here to say it's all because of you. You are the reason why I say you are the reason. why you're here this morning. But we often cast the crowns to him. Cast it crown. We lift our heads, bowing heart. It's all we hear this morning. You want to cast our crowns to him? Cast our crown. You want to lift your head?
My restorer, my life giver.
Hey! like you do, Baba. You are the living God. Oh. Hey, yes, no one can do me like you do, Lord. No one can touch me like you do, Baba. Yeah, you are the living God. Oh. No one.
Close your eyes. Father, we come before you today believing. We receive of your love. I thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated. You can give me the strings now. I want to thank you, musicians and worship leaders. Please, you can see them. Oh, you've turned it off. All right. We can read two scriptures. 2 Chronicles chapter 16. In the 6th and 30th year of the reign of Asa, Baasha king of Israel came up against Judah and built Ramah to the intent that he might not let any go out or come in to Asa king of Judah. And Asa brought out silver and gold out of the treasures of the house of the Lord and of the king's house, and sent to Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, that dwelt at Damascus, saying, there's a league between me and thee, and there, as there was between my father and thy father. Behold, I've sent thee silver and gold. Break that league with Baasha, king of Israel, that he may depart from me. Ben-Hadad hearkened unto King Asa, and sent the captains of his army against the city of Israel. And they smote Ijon, and Dan, and Abel-Maim, and all the store cities of Naphtali. And it came to pass, when Baasha heard it, that he left off building of Ramah, and let his work cease. Then Asa the king took all Judah, and they carried away the stones of Ramah and timber thereof, wherewith Baasha was building, and he built there with Geba and Mizpah. And at that time Hanani the seer came to Asa, king of Judah, and said unto him, because thou hast relied on the king of Syria and not relied on the Lord thy God, therefore is the host of the king of Syria escaped out of your hand. Were not the Ethiopians and the Lubims a huge host with very many chariots and horsemen? Yet because thou didst rely on the Lord, he delivered them into your hand. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in the behalf of them whose heart is perfect towards him. There, herein thou hast done foolishly. Therefore, from henceforth, thou shalt have wars. Then Asa was angry with the seer and put him in prison, for he was enraged with him because of this thing. And Asa oppressed some of the people at the same time. Okay. Let's pray. Lord, touch our hearts and bless us. In Jesus' name. Amen. All right. It's good to have you here. If I haven't seen a very long time, thank you for coming. And we have a special guest, Minister Kofi. Thank you. Let me see if I can spend some few minutes exhorting you and sharing the word of the Lord with you. Some few minutes. And we can speak into some people's lives in prophesying or in prophecy, and then we will let you go. Amen. In everybody's life, there are low moments where you are not at your best, and where it looks like you're going through you know, some struggles in your life. And when you out of it, and from hindsight, I mean, you look at what actually happened, and you begin to take stock or have an objective perspective or a broader view of what just happened or what happened or what you went through, you would realize that those low moments were not necessarily the most difficult problems you had to deal with. And you wonder how come you were able to deal with bigger problems, and then this seemingly small one overwhelmed you. How many of you can identify what I'm talking about? Okay. That was what happened to Asa, King Asa. King Asa was one of the best kings of Judah. Nice guy. He did what was right in the sight of the Lord. And the Lubims and the Ethiopians came with, I think, 1 million soldiers with iron chariots. And Asa depended on God, trusted in God, and whipped them, overcame all of them. Then one day Syria came against Asa. The Syrians were who? The Syrians were actually supposed to be under the Israel, under Israel. Actually, the blessings you know, Jacob was from Syria, actually. A Syrian ready to perish was my father. That was what the Israelites said every time they brought their tithes. So it was Jacob's blessing that flowed into Syria. So the Syrians were just people who were, it was like a shadow of Israel, benefiting from the blessings and prosperities of Israel. When God asked Elijah to hand over his mantle to three people, he said, anoint Elisha, the son of Shaphat of Abel Mehola, to be a prophet in your room, in your stead. And anoint Jehu, the son of Nimshi, over Israel. And anoint Hazael to be king over Syria. So right there you see in the dealing of God, is it a prophet from Israel? Is it Jehu from Israel? And then he said, anoint even the Syrian king. Anoint this man to be king of Assyria. Assyria always benefited from Israel's blessings. So Syria was actually under Israel. It was just a friend to Israel. But there was this rivalry. The Syrians felt they are big boys. But you see, sometimes when you have poor leadership, then you fail to be in charge. So Syria came against Israel, came against Judah. Sorry. Israel, which was the northern kingdom, came against Judah. Those of you who know the story. Israel was one nation, but it divided after Solomon. Because of idol worship, God said, I'm taking the kingdom from you. So the kingdom was divided. 10 tribes went to the north, called Israel. And then 2 tribes, Benjamin and Judah, but it's called Judah, came down. So the 10 tribes was now called Israel, and the southern tribes were now called Judah. God's covenant was Israel, remain with Judah. Because the 10 tribes led by Jeroboam went into idol worship. But God kept his covenant with the house of David, which was Judah. Now, 19 kings ruled over Israel, the northern kingdom. 20 kings ruled over Judah. Out of all the 19 kings that ruled over Israel, the northern kingdom, none were saved. Because they walked in the ways of Jeroboam. They continued with the sin of Jeroboam. Jeroboam made idols for Israel and said, if I allow this people to go down to the south, which is Judah, where the temple of God is, eventually their heart will be united to their king and they will come and kill me. So let me make gods for them. A leader is somebody who gives, who knows the true needs of people and give to them, not making idols for people. Anyway, if God gave you the kingdom, what are you afraid of? It was God who tore the kingdom from Israel, from the house of David, and gave 10 tribes to you. You have 10 tribes, and the other guy has only 2. I'm talking about Jeroboam and Rehoboam. Jeroboam made idols. He put one in Dan and put the other in Bethel and said, don't go to Jerusalem. Don't go to the south. Don't go to Judah. Just stay here. These are your gods that brought you out of Egypt. And all the 19 kings walk in the sins of Jeroboam. Now, if you've ever read about the sin of Jeroboam, God also was very angry with Jeroboam. He talks about the sin of Jeroboam. What was the sin of Jeroboam? Idol worship? No. As for idol, there are people who worship it until. People always find something to worship. But the sin of Jeroboam was institutionalizing. You see, if you are gay, there's no problem. We can help you. If you're a lesbian, we can help you. If you have personality identification disorder, which is taflache, a mental problem, you are a man, you think you are a woman, we can help you. But to institutionalize the thing, that is the problem. We don't have a problem against gays, lesbians, bisexual, transgender. In fact, they need our pity because they have a problem, mental problem. Now, about you have a mental problem and you want to institutionalize it, impose it on us. Sabi wabodamana. What is our job? Our job is to help people, make everybody go to heaven. So if you are gay, there's no problem. We can help you. If you're lesbian, we can help you. But to become the strongest social movement, the strongest social movement, with a demonic agenda, you see men marrying men. You know, when they were doing the Olympics game, I was waiting to see men's relay. I was expecting to see the guys who are men and they are calling themselves women. I was expecting them to at least show us the confusion there, who they really are. But it's men and women, that's all. You can't be both, or you can't be men and women. Anyway. In Van Tunche. So the kings, the 19 kings of, what's the name? Of Israel, walked in the sins of Jeroboam. Jeroboam institutionalized idol worship, became a national god. All the 19 kings. But 8 out of the southern kingdom, which is Judah, 8 of them were saved. At a point, they were trying to copy. In fact, God was speaking about it. He said, you people. Israel broke my heart, and you people are trying to copy them. You know, just sleeping around with idols. But at least 8 kings. So all the good kings in the Bible that you know about, they are from the southern kingdom or Judah. Do you understand? Kings like what? Who are the nice kings in the Bible? Huh? Before the division of the kingdom, okay, we had Saul, we had David, we had Solomon. After that, the kingdom divided. So we are talking about the rest of the kings. Who are the nice guys? Jehoshaphat, thank you. Hezekiah, thank you. Oh, I have Bible students here. Who said Josiah? Who said Josiah? Oh, yeah. Josiah. That was one of my favorite kings. No, Cyrus was not a king of Israel. He was an emperor. Yes. King Joash. I think Joash was a king of Israel. Manasseh was a very bad king. He was actually the worst. I'm not that Manasseh the king. I'm the original Manasseh in the Bible. No, let me explain. As for that guy, he just took our name. It was Joseph who gave, you know, Joseph had 2 sons. His firstborn was Manasseh. So that's the genuine one. One of the kings also took the name and did a lot of bad things, but now we have some clean Manasses here. Why are you not mentioning Uzziah? King Uzziah. Hallelujah. Josiah Uzziah. Josiah. Jehoshaphat. You mentioned all the great guys. So Asa was one of those 8 clean guys. Clean guy. Hallelujah. Great guy. And the Ethiopians and the Lubims, these guys were giants with so many soldiers, iron chariots, came against King Asa. King Asa relied on God. Relied on God. Trusted in God. And God delivered him. Then Baasha, the king of Israel, stood against. He came and tried to besiege Israel by building a city to hedge him in. And Asa went and took, we read it. The thing wants my face. Asa brought out the silver and gold out of the treasure of the house of the Lord. He went and took the gold and the silver in God's house. And went and gave it to the king of Syria. That break your covenant, your league with the king of Israel, Baasha. And come and defend me. And so the king of Syria sent soldiers to go and destroy what the Israelites were doing. And then they stopped building and they left. And Asa was free. And when he got to his home and was removing his dress, he said they should bring him some juice, some wine to drink. No, they said there's a prophet standing there at the door. The prophet said, King Asa, you, were the Ethiopians and Lubims, not a greater, were not the Ethiopians and the Lubims a huge host with very many chariots and horsemen? Yet because thou did rely on the Lord, he delivered them to your hand. Now look at what you've done. For the eyes of the Lord run through and fro throughout the whole earth to show himself strong in behalf of those whose heart is perfect towards him. Wherein thou hast done foolishly, therefore from henceforth thou shalt have wars. Now, if you want to know where war starts from, I'm talking of unrest, confusion, trouble in your life, this is where it starts from. He said there were new gods and there was war. Once your trust in God shifts into something, you've invited trouble. He said, thou hast done foolishly. And from now, you begin to have wars. Amen. Amen. All right. So let me just tell you what I want to tell you. Sometimes these stories will help us remember the sermon. Let me tell you what I want to tell you and then I get out of your way. You see, Matthew chapter 11, verse 29 and 30. You can read from verse 28. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Do you see that? Now, we used to leave this scripture for the unbelievers. Come unto me, all ye that labor. Anyone who is laboring, you're struggling, you're hustling. You are tired. You are stressed. Jesus says, come to me and I will give you rest. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Next line. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I'm meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto your souls. Now, he says, you come to me, I'll give you rest. But now he's saying that take my yoke on you and then learn of me. For meek and lowly in heart, it's in parentheses, in brackets. And you'll find rest. He says, take my yoke upon you, learn of me, and I'll give you rest. Now, first he said, come and I'll give you rest. Then, now he says, as you have come, take my yoke, learn from me, and you have rest. The rest there is talking about rest, repose, refreshment, refreshing. Hallelujah. The last line. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Now look at it. You are carrying a burden and you are heavy laden and you have come and Jesus says, you come and carry my, put yours down and carry mine. You see, that's how it works. You see, to cease from your own works, you have to get into the work of the Lord. It says, labor to enter into your rest. Wow. I thought to rest, you rest. But he said, you labor to enter into the rest. But he said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Amen? What are we supposed to labor in word and doctrine? Because the rest is talking about entering into the rest refers to trust, believe. Bible says they could not enter because of unbelief. In fact, we can read it. The Bible says God rested on the seventh day. Then Paul was saying that it's not just about God resting. Because after that rest, God talked about another rest. He said the people that were promised couldn't enter into the rest because of unbelief. Now remember, it's the same word for it's the same thing as trust. Belief is trust. Faith is trust. They couldn't enter because of unbelief. So he said, if Joshua had given them rest, God would not have talked about, which means the people entered into their promised land, which was supposed to be their rest. But there remains a rest to the people of God. And those to whom it was promised did not enter because of unbelief. So God had to set another time, another space. He limited another space in David, in Psalms, and said, if they enter into my rest. And he said, anyone who has believed has entered into the rest of the Lord. And said, let us labor to enter into his rest. For the word of the Lord is alive. Sharper than any two-edged sword, and blah, blah, blah. So the word of the Lord is what gives you your rest. When you believe the word, you enter into your rest. Amen. All I'm saying is that when you come to the place of trust, you come to the place of your rest. Amen. 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 All right. So, let's see if we can read it. Let's see if we can read it. Where is it? Hebrews 4, right? Okay, so let's look at it. Hebrews 4, from verse 1. Let's read it one go. Let us therefore fear, lest the promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. Now, he was talking about people who were backsliding. You know, the letter to the Hebrews was written to those Jews who believed, but later they wanted to go back to the world. Some of them felt, oh, let's go back to the law. So Paul wrote a long letter to exhort them and teach them on the Levitical priesthood, that it was actually a shadow of the reality, which is Christ. So it was an exhortation, encouraging them, but also warning them of apostasy, falling away. So he said, let us therefore fear, lest a promise being left us of entering into his rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. For the gospel was, for unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them. But the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it. Stop right here. Now, he said, we should fear lest a promise that is left for us, any of us should seem to come, we should seem as if we are coming short of it. We should be careful. Then he said, because the gospel that was preached is a continuation. Which means that the rest is in the gospel. He said, and the rest is about our faith. He said that those who heard it did not mix it with faith. That was a problem. So the rest is in the trust, it's in the faith. Amen? But let's read on. For we which have believed do enter into rest, as he has said, as I have sworn in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished from the foundation of the earth. Now at a point God swore that they won't enter into his rest. He swore to the Israelites that they won't enter into the promised land. Now, though there was already rest, though God had finished everything and there was already rest, God said some people will not enter into the rest. It's the same thing that Jesus has finished everything for us, but we have to believe to enter into his rest. Now, in a sense, in a general sense, you are in your rest, but you can have more rest as your trust in the Lord becomes entire. Hallelujah. For he spake in a certain place of the seventh day on this wise, that God did rest the seventh day from all his works. Let's read it. I've explained it, so let's read it. And in this place again, if they shall enter into my rest. Seeing therefore that it remained that some must enter into therein, enter therein, and they to whom it was first preached entered not because of unbelief. Did you see that? Again, he limited a certain place, saying in David or in Psalms, today, after so long a time, as it is said, today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart. Which means that, hold it. Which means that entering into your rest has got to do with hearing God's voice or God's word and allowing it to enter into your heart. Believe is simply allowing the word of God to enter into your heart. Now, God calls unbelief hardness of heart. Usually, we refer to hardness of heart as stubbornness in doing the wrong thing. And that's correct. But God is talking about hardness of heart here in the context of unbelief. He said, let the word sink into your heart. That's how you enter your rest. The assurance and quietness and peace. Next line. Okay, today if you hear his voice, today if you will hear his voice, harden not your heart. If Jesus, that the word there is Joshua, please. The word, for if Joshua had given them rest, then would he not afterward? You know, Jesus is English. Joshua is Hebrew. So it's the same thing. Do you understand? It's like you say Yesu or Jesus. Do you understand? But the right word is Yesu. Yesu, Yesu, yeah. We say, you know. I hear there's no J in the Hebrew alphabet. So it's Yesu. Yeshua. It's the same thing. Okay. Jesus or Yeshua or Yeshua. Okay. If Joshua had given them rest, he was talking about the Israelites moving from Egypt into the promised land. He said, if Joshua had given them rest, then God shouldn't be talking about another rest. Uh-huh. So there remained therefore a rest to the people of God. You see, he was talking to the Jews, so they understand, they know the history, they know this. He was talking about, the rest is in Jesus. And he wanted them to believe in Jesus. Uh-huh. Therefore, a rest to the people of God. Verse 10. For he that entered into his rest has also ceased from his own works as God did from his. Now, this is it. When you enter into God's rest, you cease from your own works. In fact, the word rest is the word Sabbath. Sabbath. This whole thing about Sabbath is the realm of faith, trust, and assurance, coupled with the peace. In receiving the divine work as opposed to our own struggles and works in the flesh and toil. God is not against you working. He has every problem with the works of the flesh. Anxiety, worry, you know, and pride. Something you can boast about. Hallelujah. Now, there is a young man who has set a record, a national record. I don't know if it's national or West Africa record. He's from this church. He's in this church. It's all over the news. He had 4 straight A's at A level. Usually people do 3 subjects. He did 4. His lowest grade was 94. Of course, best things always come from water garden. You know, we are always the best by the grace of God. And he's all over the news. He did the same at O levels. He took it. All of us, he took it, the whole nation. And A levels, he set a record, flat. He's in this church. And we're talking about him yesterday, and my daughter said, look at this guy, he's so cool. He's not trying to change the world and trying to, when you talk to him, he's cool as if nothing happened. He's cool. He's not trying to change the whole world. Clap. Oh, you remember when he blew the O-level one, we brought him here and just thank God for his life. How many of you were in service that day? And this time he's blown it. Blown it big. Mass, physics, chemistry, IT. A plus one. Blew the thing. Of course. I mean, what should you expect? If the person is coming from Watered Garden. I mean, Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But the point here is, you know, my daughter was chatting yesterday, and he said, this guy, and he's not trying to change the world, though. It's not like a big vision to change the world. No. It's like Moses who opened the Red Sea and he didn't start Red Sea opening ministries. In fact, he just opened the Red Sea, they walked through and he left as if nothing happened. He never even talked about it. You know, watered garden, the testimonies are too much. We don't even... Oh, beautiful church. Amen. Amen. So I'm going to stop right here so we can prophesy to you before you go. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Cease from... Anyone who's entered into the rest of God has ceased from his own ways. You've stopped struggling. Amen? Amen? Yeah. Say, I've ceased from my own works. You know, people have been trying, struggling. No. End time to God's rest. Amen. Honey, you are a believer. You are not a hustler. Don't make yourself a hustler. You are a child of God. You entered into God's rest. Amen. Believe. Amen. Amen. Don't live in a perpetual stress. Amen. God doesn't like it. God doesn't like it because it shows you are in the flesh. God doesn't like stress because stress shows you are in the flesh. You are not doing something right. You are trying to be your own God. Solve all your own problems. Solve everybody's problems. No. Don't do that. Don't do that. Don't do that. It is time to rest. Amen? Amen. Let's finish this and see. Let's finish. Let us labor therefore to enter into the rest, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. Did you see that? So, boot for boot. He's showing you that unbelief, rest. Unbelief, belief, rest. Unbelief, war, trouble. Okay? Uh-huh. For the word of the Lord is alive, you know, and all that. Okay. Psalm 23. As we close, Psalm 23. I don't even know why I preached, but maybe it may benefit somebody. Because, honestly speaking, I was just going to minister the prophetic today, but yesterday we had a blast here, so I say, you never know. Let me just open my mouth. God may say something else again. How many of you were here last night? All of you were here last night. Hallelujah. Yesterday was a blast, right? Unfortunately, it's not on Facebook. Yeah. Oh. The only way you can get it is to go and register online. At a fee. And then we can get it for you. Amen. 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 So Psalm 23, let's go. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in... Does it look like somebody who's struggling? Hustler. No, like the man here, does he sound like a hustler? He says he's what? He's doing what? He's lying down where? He's lying down in what? Come on. Amen. Be on your feet and confess these things. The Lord is my... Some of you, only God knows who is taking care of you. Hallelujah. The Lord is my... Are you sure of that? Oh, you are your own father. You are your own... You see, you hear some wife say, I'm the husband, oh, I'm the man, oh, and then... Hear some people say, I have a father, but you see, I don't have a father. I'm my own father, and I'm my own mother. No, don't be your own father. Don't be your own mother. The Lord is your shepherd. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord is your... And you shall not want. The want there is what? Lack. You won't lack. He maketh. You see, that's the problem. No, that's the point. If truly you come to the Lord, he will make you to lie down. You just sit down here. You know, that's the story of Mary and Martha. Mary sat down, was hearing his word. Martha was, action. Action woman, fire woman. He leadeth me beside the still waters. Says, he leads me beside the still waters. In fact, the Hebrew says the waters of great quietness. Yeah, that's your rest. Repose. Amen. Amen. Not troubled waters. Amen. Apostle Vito was teaching yesterday about sheep. No sheep likes troubled waters. It's true. Yeah. Calm. And the big one is this one. He restoreth my soul. He refreshes. Amen. All right. Yeah, just keep playing. Open your mouth and just bless the Lord. No, just lift up in the sun. Lift up your hands.
There's a shifting in the atmosphere. The glory of the Lord is in this place, just like Pentecost. There's a mighty rushing wind, breathing life and comfort to your soul, peace and calmness fixing every woe, just like Pentecost. There's a mighty rush in the wind, there's a shifting, there's a shifting in the atmosphere, the glory. Come on, breathing life and comfort to your soul.
Breathing life and comfort to your soul. Peace and calmness fixing every woe. Just like Pentecost,
that's a mighty rushing wind.
There's a mighty rushing wind.
Come on, say it's moving. It's moving in.
all you that labor and heavy laden, I'll give you rest. Whatever load you're carrying this morning, you just cast it. He said, throw it. Cast means throw. Casting all your burdens upon him, for he cares for you. He said, just lay it at my feet. Just throw it. He said, you don't even need to carry it all the way down. Wherever you are, just throw it off. I will give you rest. I will give you rest. Today, whatever burden it is, maybe a relationship, maybe finances, maybe your health. You're not leaving this place without burden. You're not carrying it back. Hallelujah. Let's rest for you. Let's rest for you. Blessed assurance. Just sing. When you start singing, they'll play. Blessed assurance.
Jesus is mine.
Come, pick it up.
Oh, the fortress
of glory divine.
Heroes of salvation, pledges of God. All of his spirit, washing his blood.
Echoes Spirit. Now open your mouth and just begin to speak in tongues. Father, we give you all the glory and the praise. Thank you for miracles right now. We give you all the worship and praise. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, lady, I saw rain falling on both of you, but for two reasons. The rain stands for the anointing of the Holy Spirit, but for two reasons. Yours is a prophetic and ministry. Yours is money, wealth. The same rain is falling between the two of you, but it's producing a prophetic anointing. An understanding. Lady, what do you do? You're going to start making so much money and so much wealth. Give me the oil. I release your millions as God's prophet. Sir, come. You preach. You preach. Father, let the apostolic mantle. Are you married? You're married. Fall upon your son and my daughter. I see your wife. I see the bushy hair. And I see the anointing coming strong, cutting through her, literally. And go back for me a little. God is going to use her so mightily, and God is going to use you. You are going to do great things. You're going to take kingdoms and nations for Christ. Yeah, yeah. Just keep playing the keyboard. Don't stop. Maybe the same song, same tempo. Okay. Radhadabasanta. The Lord says, I should say to you that He's pleased with you. I saw you in the garden of Eden, and I see the onyx. Come on. I see the cherub, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father God. Master Kadotos Paratos. The Lord is giving you a rod to rule with. The Lord is giving you mastery, courage, confidence. And I see your two. Let me say sons, because a girl and a boy, but I see your two sons as armors in your hands. I saw some books over you opened, and I had favor. It is your time of favor. Lady, we rebuke darkness. Any darkness that pursued you, and any darkness you are pursuing, we rebuke it now. It stops now. Are you planning to
to travel? Are you trying to pursue something overseas? Hold on for me. You have a man in your life? You don't have any man in your life. Sure? You say not currently. It means there was. And you were no longer together. He left. But you are still pursuing him. And you see, you are actually chasing darkness. Oh yeah. Is he in this country? Is he planning to go out of the country? You don't know. Today, we sanctify you. You are a princess. The darkness is past. In Jesus' name. Don't go after him. That thing is over. Okay? That was darkness. Now you are in the light. And you are a princess. G-O. Sounds familiar? Any name with G O that sounds familiar to you? All right. What's your name? You know, the Lord is healing you from all the wounds. That's why God brought you here today. The Lord opened the wounds and I said I should look at it. But I'm telling you, you leave this service laughing. This is exactly what Jesus is doing. Holding your hands. And healing you. Poranda basata mashakatura babarababaratos. Every Goliath in your life, we pull it down. The Lord heal you. The Lord heal you. The Lord heal you. I see God do something new for you. From the month of June through this August. Oh, we are sorry. We're sorry. Somebody should have been taking care of your child for you. We're sorry. Thank you, Jesus. You are entering into your rest. The one who takes care of me is a good shepherd. I'm talking about you. Father, we praise you.
We praise your name. We praise
For your daughter, thank you for the blessing, thank you for the season of refreshing, thank you for your hand that is upon her life. See, I bless you. See, I bless you. See, I bless you. My dear, it's done. It's done. God bless you. Gentlemen, can you come? Yes. The Lord bless you. Okay, you can wait somewhere there for me. Madam, what do you do? Sorry? You see, it's very interesting. Now, God wants to give you a transport. She's a caterer. God wants to give you a transport business. You understand? Invest into transport, okay? All right. Do you have any vehicle? Do you have any vehicle? You don't have any vehicle yet. Father, in the next 6 months, 2 weeks, we release her vehicles. How great is our God. Lady, come. See with me.
How great is our God.
Gentlemen, come.
Oh, see.
Sorry, no user.
How great is our God.
My hand is on you, said the Lord.
How great.
Now,
it's our God.
Come, the two of
you.
Sing. You know, you've been seeing visions. You've been seeing things. You've been seeing visions. You've been seeing things. Visions. You've been seeing things. You see things into the spirit, right? You see things in the spirit. Are you born again? Sure. Okay. What church do you attend? Oh, your husband is a pastor. Oh. That's why you've been seeing visions. You've been seeing visions. You've been seeing a lot of visions. You've seen a lot of visions. You also have the call of God on your life. Yeah, you are called. And the Holy Spirit. No. Raise your head a little bit.
See with me how great is our God.
Now, madam, you see everything, right? No, no, I'm asking. You see everything, right? Anything that will happen, you just see all of them. You just see them. You just keep seeing things, correct? You see everything, correct? When did this manifestation start? Like how many years? 4 or 5 years now. You just see things. Father, sanctify your daughter. You're the name above all names. Senior, what do? You just finished with your national service. Let me just say something to you. The next 4 to 6 years of your life, from this minute that I'm talking, you're supposed to make it big. See, the next 6 to 4 years of your life is your life. Everything must happen. Yes, within 4 to 6 years, these 4 to 6 years of your life. This gentleman should be able to employ all of us here. See, you are going to network the world. You're going to put the world into 4 boxes and connect the whole world. You are going to set up systems. As for money, I'm talking about several millions of dollars. Too much money. And so when you go out of here, just go back into your room and start creating systems and all the ideas. Because the things this guy is going to do, did I say all of us here? Talking about, he's going to employ about 1/4 of the world. You know how everybody uses a mobile phone today? You see the way the Uber app is all over the world today? So this is one of the guys. Sometimes there's just a church service just for one person. A whole church service just for one person. We may think we are doing our own thing, but God is also doing his own thing. V. Oh. I missed you. Oh. There's only one CEO. One official CEO. And that's Lady V. Come on. Now, do you have land? You don't have land. Are you working on any land? You're not working on any land. Oh, senior. Do you have any land? Oh. You don't have any land. You're not working on any land. The land, now, whose is it? The land you are on, whose is it? There's no land. You don't have a land. Your mother, your father, or I see a sea plot land. I see a six plot land. No, release this hand. I see a six plot land. And two of the plot has already been taken. It's already in your hands. And the four other plots. What do you do? Sorry? So you're not doing anything now? Do your hands this way. Where do you live? That's your mother's house? Okay. You rented this place. Gentlemen, there is a six plot land that God has given to you. And I'm surprised you say you're not working on any land. I'm shocked. Because the thing is in two plots out of the six is already in your name. Yeah. Two of the plots is already. I'm not getting this. You don't have any idea about any land. Your brother or somebody or anybody, land. Whoa. And you're not working on any land. This one. Okay, anyway. So, there is, and it happens all the time, you know. They will come back telling you, oh, prophet, you know. give me the oil. So there is a six plot land. Two had been plotted already in your name. And the Lord told me that it's a land you're working on. And the Lord says, I should say to you that everything starts from that land. Has somebody spoken to you about a land that he wants to give a land to you, or he wants you to buy a land, or well, I'm selling a land, can I show you, or anything? Is there anything like that? How many plots? When did he tell you this? About a month ago. Yes, he said, if you want the land, you should contact him. Call him when you go out of this door and ask him how many plots. Because the Lord told me you are working on a land and he will give you the two plots. They already plotted in your name. So you buy the two plots, but it's a six plot. I'm seeing it. It's a vision. So I'm seeing it. So you pay for the two plots. Don't say you don't have money. Just tell him you are buying it. And immediately the money will come. And then you make a deposit. You just make a deposit. The Lord says to me to say to you that everything begins, everything will happen on that land. Sir, senior. You are a millionaire, but the secret is in that land. The land. That forget about anything. Even looking for a job, forget about it. Just look for the land. I don't have money. The land first. When you go out of this door, call the guy, tell him you want the land, pa. Ask him how many plots. Because I'm seeing six plots. And then, even if you say it's two plots, that is the two plots you want to sell, but the whole thing is six. Tell him you are taking the two plots, and God will give you some money, you make a deposit. Because God is telling me that everything starts from that land. Father, today I thank you. I thank you. In Jesus' holy name. Amen. Now let me put this in, and everybody listen. You know, Pastor Edward said something here. He said the Bible says, it says, all of you may prophesy, that all of you may learn.
And he said that he learns when I'm prophesying. Were you the one who said it all, Pastor Ed? Pastor Ed. So when we are prophesying, you can be learning. You understand? You see, you went out of the will of God. He confirms, he says it's true. And that is how come you went under that shelter temporarily. Because you are, oh, your dish here, you are a royal. I see things are not going well because you went out of God, the will of God, for a while. But your dignity and your glory is returning now. And that is why God is saying that that land is for you. God, there's no royal who doesn't have land. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? You have land. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you that it's done tonight, today. We give you all the praise. And we love you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let me tell you this. Everything is happening. Now, these things you are hearing, assuming I didn't call them, it doesn't mean it won't happen. Uh-huh. So the fact that I haven't called you doesn't mean nothing's happening. It's happening. I'm just informing you that is what, so you will know. Amen. Amen. So don't feel sad at me that I didn't get prophecy. No. You have the blessing. Amen. 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 All right. I'm not done with you people, but we have already crossed the time. So I'll just let you go. And but I haven't ministered to you yet. Have I? I haven't. Good. Now, lady, do you have a sister? You don't have a sister. Do you have somebody who you will call a sister, who is so close to you, you do business or you do something together, you do things together, a friend or something that you will call a sister? Do you have somebody like that? Who is he? Is he a friend? Or a cousin? Or a relation? Or a friend? Your friend. You do everything together? What? Okay. Where is she? No? No? Can't you see that when you people are pulling apart, things are not working well for both of you? No? You are sisters, oh. Seriously. You've already wasted 2 years. Yeah. The same thing about her too. You will have to reconnect, bam, immediately. Because that's how God designed it, that the two of you. Or some man is trying to separate both of you. Okay, all right. So there's no big deal about that. Immediately. You see it? As soon as you become the ideas, it will be like, back, 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 back. Say back, 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 back. Amen. So there's this business that going to take off. As soon as people come together, the ideas will start coming. The doors will be opening for her. Aye, 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 and you. Insurance, every other door. What do? You work with an IT company. What does she do? Doors will open for, start opening for both of you. I bless 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 you. Hey, my friend, where have you been? Good. Now give me your hand. Today I release your wealth. I release your monies. I release your monies. I release your monies. Now, lady. This thing is supposed to happen in March, but March is too far away. Okay? We are going to release your monies. Okay? I see the paws of a tiger. I see the paws of a tiger. The two paws of a tiger. And we're going to release your monies. There's two huge monies that are locked up that we are releasing now. Amen. It's supposed to come in March, but March is too far. It must happen in this August. Hallelujah. Open your mouth, stretch your hand to us. We release it now. We release it now. We release it now. Can you come? My dear, can you come? Angie, come. Lady, I'll pray for you. In the name of Jesus. In the holy name of Jesus. Amen. Now, my dear, come. When we're praying, the Lord told me, he said, as soon as she connects with her sister, it's done. You get the money. As soon as the money comes, the first person to see is Prophet Manasseh. You know? He said, Prophet Manasseh, the thing has come. And then I say, yes, yes. So what do you think? Then so I think that, Charlie, we have to first fruit. Clap. Move forward. God bless you, my dear. It's done. So just get in touch quickly and tell her that the prophet told you this, that both of you have to, because both of you, God destined that both of you should be together. And yeah, so you do that. Okay. Did you actually even live together before? You actually live together. Wow. Good. God bless you. My dear, how are you? Can I see your face a little bit? Good. 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 The name is beautiful. Where have you been? But it's good to have you. Belated. Happy birthday. Now, the Lord is anointing you. Now, what do you do? Okay. There is an opportunity in an oil company. I don't know if you want it. I just saw that in the spirit. I saw this huge multinational oil company. And there's an opportunity that is coming. Because where you are working, the job is very secure. But the money is not there. But this one, big, big. And there's a man coming into your life. I think he also is with the oil company. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Darkness is past. Do you have a brother? Is he your younger brother? And younger. Okay. 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 Younger brother. Younger brother. Yeah. What does he do? The elder one. The elder of the two younger brothers. Good. Now, I want you to, you are receiving something. Stretch that hand forward as if you are receiving something. The right hand, yes, towards me. Good, good. And raise the other one. You're receiving from God. It's your time of blessing. It's your time of love. Look, everything is coming towards you. I saw somebody anoint you. When I what I saw was that
you anointed you for favor, and every good thing is coming towards you. I saw like they were gathering sticks and gathering, you know, sticks, but the sticks are made of gold. They were gathering the sticks and they were bringing all of them to you. It's your time of favor. It's your time of blessing. And I see your man. Oh, come on. I see your man. I see the glory of God on him. I bless you in Jesus' name. Now, a shoulder injury, like you've had an injury in your shoulder before. If you're here and you've had an injury, an accident in your shoulder, I want to know. Anybody? An injury in the shoulder, okay? If there's nobody here like that, I know who it is, but I was thinking there's somebody also here like that. Any other person here like that? Anybody with an injury in the shoulder? Everybody say with me, anybody here with an injury in the shoulder? Okay, senior, come. Your left shoulder. Okay, do you still have the pain? Wow. All right. Father, thank you for healing your son. We are grateful. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay. Okay. So, if I've ministered to you, you can sit down. God bless you. Good. Yes, my dear, come. God is, you are called by God for ministry. Okay? All right? You're going to be working in the church office and you're going to work, you know, like as an administrator, as a personal assistant to your general overseer, and as a woman of God. As a woman of God. Do you understand? All right. Give me the oil. Raise your head. Your head. Anoint you today for favor. Flow in the anointing. Flow in the anointing. Oh, thank you. I empower you as a woman of God. In the name of Jesus. Father, use her, Lord. Use her greatly. Use her greatly. Thank you. You're going to climb the stairs and walk to the stage. Not on a carpet, but behind the carpet. Yeah, come quickly. Good. Good. All right, good. Now you can turn. You can turn. You can come back. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. Something entered into you. Yes. Something entered into you. Lord, the anointing is on your daughter. Use her as a woman of God. Your hands are anointed. Give me the oil. Your hands are anointed. Oil, please. I give you praise. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. Good. Can you come closer? Ah, what have I done today? Today I've blown that the whole time, eh? I shouldn't have preached, you see. Shouldn't have preached. Shouldn't have preached. The anointing was on the prophecy. Shouldn't have preached. But forgive me for wasting your time. Hallelujah. Raise your hands. Lady, you see, your gift is joy. Never forget this. That's your gift. It's a gift from God. Walk in it. You function. Everybody functions aright in joy. But it's a special gift for you. You understand? Love is a fruit of the Spirit, but we have the gift of love. Joy is a fruit of the Spirit. Every believer has it, but you have it as a gift. And just walk in it. Walk in the joy. Just be happy. Just be happy. Bless everybody with this, your infectious joy. You say your name is? Wow. Even look at your name. Do you know her name? Sunshine. Whosoever gave you this name must be prophetic. Your father? Who gave you the name? Okay. Today I bless you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now, I know there are some problems. I know there's some problems, but we leave it in the past. As you move into, leave this service as if they have never made a problem. I'm from the royal family, like Ochiami or anything. You know that? You know anything about that? You don't know. Father, thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you. Good. All right. Should we prophesy to them or we should close since it's time? The people like you. They say I should prophesy to you. Amen. 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 Oh, that's beautiful. All right, so there's a scholarship for you to study abroad, okay? I don't know exactly I see Nevada is in the US, Canada also, and then I see the first one I saw was actually in the Scandinavia, Sweden, Denmark area. Okay. So I bless you today in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay. Come to me. Thank you, Father. Have you applied for some schools in London, in England? You have applied for school in England. Oh, because when you were standing there, I saw that you had applied for a school in England. Okay, so she says she applied for a school in England, but she didn't get a scholarship, so you left it. Good. So there's opening some other doors in the countries I've mentioned, okay? Okay. In the Scandinavia, the US, and Canada. Okay. Bless your daughter in Jesus' name. Amen. Vivian, now, what you need right now, I don't know if to say to employ a lot of people or to get into partnership with a lot of people. That's what you need now. You need to get involved with people, merge with, I mean, not merge, but get a lot of people to work with, to expand a lot of people. I see 8 different streams of income. 8 different streams of income. I actually saw a door open for you in Turkey. A business door. Big one from Turkey. And so some people from Turkey are going to be involved with you in business.
But God is also healing your eyes. He's healing the eyes. I see you bringing the whole family into wealth. I see a kind of global impact that is going to be made by now. Adwa. Do I have any Adwa? Do I have any Adwa here? Do I have any other Adwa? Adwa. All right. Now you just stand. Because the Lord was showing me my daughter Adwa, but I know that it's somebody else with that same name that he's referring to. Father, I thank you. Okay. Now I see two big businesses open for you. Two huge businesses open. Thank you, Father. And even your children, God is showing me your children. Show me the first one and then shows me the second one, you know, the second one, like some, you know. Little challenge, but the child will also come through. The second one will also come through clean. We'll give you glory. We'll give you praise. Thank you. Now, you're going to come this way, and let me show you something. You're going to go this way, and you're going to... It is praise, but it's the opening up. The opening up of your business. The splitting up of your business into two huge businesses. You walk this way. You just do this. As you walk there and you do that and then you come back to me. Now, have you started a business? You are a nurse. Oh, you are a nurse. Do you have a business? Hey, you are supposed to start a business. Yeah, come up. Yeah, and come up again. And then come to me. You're supposed to start a business. You're supposed to start a business now. Are you talking to somebody about business? You're talking to somebody about business. Who? A friend. What are you talking about? I won't tell anybody. All right, stand here. So we set you up now. And I even see white men involved. We set you up now. In Jesus' name, stand here. We set you up now. In Jesus' name. Amen. V. Usually I don't like to put people on a fast. But maybe the global prayer command will be enough. But we're going to just one prayer. It's just one. The prayer topic is one. My manifestation is now. And if you can do like some 1 or 2 days fast, maybe tomorrow, on the first day of the global prayer command, you can do some fast. It can be 6 to 6. On a bad day, you can go like 6 to 2. But the prayer topic is, my manifestation is now. My manifestation is now. Until we see something opening. Okay? I bless you in Jesus' name. Everybody say a big amen. Amen. I bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Place your hand on your abdomen and say, I receive total recovery in Jesus' name. Now, there's an angel I saw who came and took some things out of your body instead of the surgery and instead of what a doctor. Have you seen the doctor recently? Oh, you came from the doctor. What are they dealing with?
So I saw an angel came and took the thing out so that the doctor's procedure will be unnecessary. Amazing. Now from the doctor, what did he recommend?
Okay, they put you on painkillers for now and you go for physio. All right. So the angel has done that.
Whoa. I give you praise, Lord. Thank you for visitation. Thank you for visitation. Ah, the pain is gone. In Jesus' name. My dear, I called you. Where were you sitting? Ah, you must be standing here for like how many minutes? 45 minutes? Or even 1 hour? I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Pa. I'm sorry, Pa. It's not allowed, like I would have massaged your leg for you. If we tried now, it would be trending. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for healing. In Jesus' name. All right. Now, do you have a brother? Okay. You and your siblings, you were supposed to do a family business. You're supposed to do something together that will become a family business. You, your brother, and yourself, your brother, and your sister, you're supposed to do something together. Siblings, you're supposed to do something together. What do you do? Okay. What are you studying? Good. Your brother, what does he do? Your sister. Good. How many are you? Good. You are four in number. The three of you are supposed to do business together. It looks like a craft, but it can be a business. What do you guys in your family, what are people gifted to do? Oh, I see. I see. All right. So there is something you people have to do together as a business, okay? As a craft. I want you to go find that out from the Lord and get it started. Do you understand? Raise these hands. Father, today I declare, what's your name? That your daughter is blessed. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Don't go yet. You would have loved to travel. Where? US? China? What would you want to go and do there? You would want to go and study. Wow. Wow. All right. Raise your right hand. Father, I thank you that it is done. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen. Now, don't stop working in the house of God, because that's where the blessing is. Okay? And all your heart desires will be granted. Do you understand?
God bless you. And when you go to China, use the opportunity to start a family business. Okay. God bless you. Okay, I see that your battery is low. Because we should have closed by now. And I'm keeping you here, so I know, I understand. Tell your neighbor, prophet understands. Because some of you haven't taken your breakfast yet. Because the plan is you finish early so that we're going to take breakfast. You too, you are stretching the thing like that. So, we understand. Amen. Good. Tokpe is a Nigerian name. Tokpe. If his name is relevant to you, Tokpe, just raise your hand. If it's relevant to you, Tokpe. Okay. All right. Tokpe. Who is Tokpe? Your friend. All right. Did somebody also raise his hand? All right. Tokpe. All right. Okay. All right. Tokpe. Any other person? All right. Good. Father, I want to say thank you because of what you have done. I give you all the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. My dear, listen. The seasons of your life have changed. God has moved you forward. You are not what you used to be in the spirit. You are not what you used to be. God has moved you into a new place of blessing. Do you understand? I call it done today in Jesus' name. God will confirm what I've told you to you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Senior, you are the last man. The last man standing. Hallelujah. Just clap when you clap. Now, those of you standing, yours is not going to be long. I'm just going to touch you and then you sit down, okay? Okay, just stop the keyboard for me and let me just... Senior, I'm talking to the last man standing. How are you, sir? Okay. What do you do? Okay. Things are not going well, eh? All right. The anatomy of blessing. Now, with it clear, now, what's your mother? Are you his only son? You are the one who take care of him. You are the one who remit him. Your other brother takes care of him. Let me tell you something. Start sending money to your mother. Remit her, take care of her. And everything will change for you. That is all. I'm telling you, that's all. God bless you. Now, the rest of you come. Let me just touch you quickly. Please come. You cry. I wanted to pray for you. See, God loves you so much that I didn't. So, taking a deep breath. Down. Taking a deep breath. Now, your blood pressure, is it normal or you've been having problems with it? Okay. So we declare that it's so in Jesus' name. Amen. You have a son? Is he overseas or is he here?
He's overseas. What's his name? Good. God showed your son to me. I bless him. We establish him. Prosper. In Jesus' name. You yourself, there's some imports, okay? There's some goose, okay? That's coming for you, for business, okay? I promise these people that's not going to be long, so let me keep my word. Today the Lord honor you. Look, the first fruits of God's blessings, what God is doing. This is the first fruits of what God is doing. The first fruits of the blessing of the Lord. You are what God is doing. You are the first fruit of what God is doing. I bless you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lady, what do you do? You're doing your top up. Can I give you an advice? You're going to start selling candies, sweets. Do you understand? And maybe we'll get into the production later. Okay? Okay. So that is it. Father, thank you for your son, for your daughter. I bless her in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, so you're going to get into, we call it confectionery. Eh? You're going to get into sweets. Okay? If you have to even take a class on it, do. Okay? You're going to start selling it. Okay? From toffees to biscuits to chocolate to everything. You look like you are sad. I bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Mama, come. Father, thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Mama, there's a particular part of your brain, okay, that is being healed. Okay? I didn't say you have a brain problem, but your motor and your sight, the Lord is healing it. You see, so you can see clean and so you can walk straight. The Lord is healing it. Your nerves receive healing now, today, in Jesus' name. Amen. Sorry. Okay, so I stand in and I bless her in Jesus' name. Everybody say a big amen. All right. I hope I haven't offended you. Sure? I haven't offended you. I went beyond the time. It's okay, eh? Okay. Okay, all right. My friend, let me pray for you. Yes, sir. Come. Sir, I saw that they took some documents from you. I don't know if it's land documents or contract documents or something, but they took the documents for you. They took you very far away. But I saw keys in your hands, about 6 different keys. In other words, God is opening 6 other different doors. I declare that it is so. Now I speak over your health. Enjoy the blessing of the Lord. Thank you, Father. Give me the oil in Jesus' name. Now, if you made any vow and you have it, enjoy God's peace and blessing in Jesus' name. Amen. He's my friend, my good. Let's appreciate it. You came here with your tithe or your first fruit or your seed or your vow or your pledge. Please, can you walk up and let's do this. Yvette, we need to talk. Eh? Yeah. Need to make some time for you. You know, the Lord is going to make you so wealthy. I saw a whole national program. You sponsored it. Yeah. I saw a whole national, it was like a musical worship program for the whole nation or something, and you're one of the sponsors. Big, God is going to give you so much wealth. The Lord will bless you. No, come. I'm going to pray for you. Oh, amen. If you made any vow, or you have any pledge or any seed towards Operation Church Everywhere or our LED screen or anything, you made any vow, you can Bring it. Now I declare that this seed you've sown, you are receiving the blessings instantly in diverse ways. And something great begin for you, Mama, and every one of you here. In Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. I want you to prepare an offering for the Lord. And our musicians are going to bless us. And we'll drop our offerings and we are gone and we are done for today. Thank you for coming. Now I want you to listen very carefully to this announcement. There's something on the screen. Okay, all right, it's gone now because they have to give you the Momo because people want to pay electronic to, by electronic means. These are global prayer command. Where we pray every prayer. You know, Bible says praying with all forms of prayer, every kind of prayer. Ephesians 6:18 and 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 1. So we are supposed to pray every kind of prayer. Take care of everything. From what is happening on the international scene, Afghanistan, what's happening there, all the way to this COVID trick of the devil, all the way to your personal needs and all the details. Amen? We're going to just deal with every one of them. Hallelujah. So we are starting a 12-hour prayer this very Thursday for 7 days. We do that twice every year. We do it in January, and we do it between August and September of every year. 12-hour prayer for 7 days. Okay? So all roads lead to Watered Garden. If you know anybody wants to pray, tell him that the right place is Watered Garden. Because we are praying for 12 hours for 7 days. You don't have to pray. You don't have to stay all through. But use the opportunity to conquer your Everest. Amen? Yeah. You can even do 13. Amen? All right. So some people will come, pray, go to work, and come and finish up. Some two will go to work, come, and come and finish. Some two will start with us from 8 to 8. Amen? For 7 days. 26th, which is this coming Thursday, to the 1st of September. I was going to say the 1st of January. Like that one, by the time we say Amen, or Jesus will appear, the world will come to an end. And then everything is done, and then we'll go home. God bless you. God bless you. All right. So that's my bestie. All right. You know, when you just pray that is so many strong songs just hit my spirit. Boom, boom. Okay, I'll leave it to you people. You people will bless us with some songs. Have I prayed about your offerings? I declare that this offering also is blessed. The seed multiplied in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. Thank you.
up for Jesus. Hallelujah. If you believe you are living here with a miracle, give the Lord a loud shout. Hallelujah. Amen. Shall we share the grace? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we are dwelling in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and have a great, prosperous, and wonderful week. Amen.